in guarding him, but clearly this was a very well-financed, very well-planned operation. The assailants arrived in 9 new Nissan Patrol vehicles. They knew the layout of the presidential compound, and they apparently used a ruse of saying they were DEA to get in. So they may have tricked some of the security. But if they knew the compound, they may have had inside sources. So we don't know if the presidential guard or elements of the presidential guard were, working with them, colluding in some way. But for sure, the operation was not something spontaneous. It had been planned for a long time and cost a lot of money, because the fact is the government has very little authority. The state authority is practically nil, which is why you have basically armed neighborhood groups running the country now. You have all of Port-au-Prince is essentially divided up really between two warring factions. And one of them is calling for a revolution, not just against Jovenel and against his bourgeois opposition, but against the whole system in Haiti. So they're demanding a very thorough, very deep-seated revolution. And so we're going to see a lot of tumult in the days ahead. It really all dates back to the U.S. Sponsored and backed coup d'etat of 1991 against former President Jean-Bertrand Aristide. And we could even trace it back to the 1915 military occupation that the U.S. Marines brought for 19 years, from 1915 to 1934. Basically, the U.S. has been meddling in Haitian affairs nonstop for the past century, and the result is this: a state which is weak and dysfunctional, and they don't care about the people who are rising up in the shanty towns of Port-au-Prince. 50 years ago, Haiti was an agricultural country. Now all those peasants have been destroyed through U.S. dumping of rice and everything else, also from the Dominican Republic. And this means all the peasants have moved to the cities where they're living with no jobs and trying to eke out some kind of life. And then you had gangs emerge doing kidnapping. So this is the state of anarchy that you have in Haiti, which to me, Washington has a big hand in, this uprising from the grassroots, from the base. Washington was hoping that they could keep this neo-devaluerist group in, which they more or less ushered in 2010 and 2011, when Hillary Clinton went down to Haiti and basically said, put in Michel Martelly. Michel Martelly gave us Jovenel Moïse. And basically the two of them plundered the earthquake funds. They plundered the Petrocaribe fund, which was about a $2 billion account fed by revenues from cheap Venezuelan oil. But because Donald Trump put sanctions on Venezuela, that Petrocaribe fund ended. So Haiti has been without any kind of support. And you have this, I could call it a clown mafia, who was in charge of the country. And so the people have finally been fed up and are rising up in some kind of revolution. That's what they themselves say. So I think that this might have been a fifth strike, because they see that, you know, if they don't do something fast, things could be much, much worse, and there could be a very thoroughgoing, profound revolution in Haiti. Mm-hmm.